This is a breakdown of Eat Out from my new album Alescere, which is available on streaming and on Bandcamp as download and limited edition cassette. In this video, we'll check out using FM as percussion for a double noise effect and creating a pitched cowbell. So let's check out the double noise effect first. I'll start the song here. And you can already hear there's kind of like a crackle in the background. That's on the end channel where my cursor is. And it's kind of gradually becoming more intense. And all of this distortion is on the noise channel right now. And this is where the double noise effect comes in. So we've still got the 8 on the bottom, which is the distortion. But we've also got that kind of noise percussion going on. That's kind of like we've got two noise effects going on right now. And now we're just back into one noise. Okay, so let's have a look at the noise channel first for just the distortion. So that was pattern 8 on the end channel. So yeah, this is just the noise channel. There's nothing else going on here, and it's creating quite a nice nice distortion. So we can have a look at this. So it's an arp, and all of the arp steps are the lowest note. We've got kind of like an LFO going on here. It does seem to modulate it slightly on the pitch. And then we've just got a very, very low metallic noise, I think. Whatever this two lines is, I think is metallic noise. It's just a very, very low noise effect. But that's the noise distortion on the end channel, at least. And then we've got pattern A, which came in on the L channel, which actually provided us our double noise effect. So this, I think, is probably the more interesting one. This is kind of using FM at a very high modulation to mimic noise. But it's fairly specific in Nanoloop, as all the sounds are wavetabled, as far as I'm aware. So yeah, you have to be, you know, in kind of like the right spot to create this. So we can have a look. I usually use arps for most of my noise percussion, especially snares, just to kind of like loop, well, just to give them a bit more body. So I kind of like, as it hits, it kind of goes up and then back down. So like C is the root note, we go 4 semitones up and then back down to 0, which is C. I guess I've used it for everything here, probably out of laziness more than anything. The LFO is quite significant, so if we reduce the modulation here, it basically is doing kind of half the work, and the other half is over here with the kind of the instrument noise settings. So we've got quite a high modulation on the FM over here. They are vertical lines, but it doesn't really matter if they're horizontal or vertical. As far as I'm aware, at least, I think it's a bug. So if we just move this down to the left slightly, or over to the left, We've already got quite a different sound, and you can hear it's more FM than it is noise. And if we move it a little bit to the right, we kind of get a bit more noisy. And then it kind of goes into kind of heavily modulated FM again. And it does have to be quite high up as well in terms of where the position of the graphic, I suppose, in the box. So if we move it down, there's just not enough frequency modulation. So yeah, it kind of falls down. But that's the two effects, and then combining them, of course. Yeah, you can use the noise channel for different effects and still keep a percussion in another channel, which is pretty sweet. So I can listen to that in context again. Just wait for the loop. I think it's quite interesting. It's always nice to find those kind of extra hacks which allow you to kind of get a bit weird with your tracks. And when I say weird, take up the whole noise channel with distortion. And then we're into this next section of the track, which has this pitched cowbell, which we'll look into now. Okay, so this is pattern C, even though it doesn't say it is, but yes it is. And this is the pitched cowbell. It's another FM instrument. And yeah, fairly high modulation again, but not too crazy. The pitch slide is sort of... doesn't seem like it's doing a whole lot. It probably is, but... Yeah. Anyway, so the pitch slide isn't too important. I suppose the octave is. Sounds pretty cool, though. And obviously the position of the FM is... that's all that really goes into that, and then I expose quite a short volume envelope. Yeah, it's quite a nice sound. The randomization, I think, is this. Yeah, so pressing start on this kind of like three juggling balls. They look like juggling balls to me. Turns on the step randomizer. And that will be saved in the pattern when you save it in the bank screen as well. Oh yeah, a bit of a heavier one there. Yeah, so that's the three instruments or effects that I wanted to show off in Eat Out. The rest of this series, there should be 8 parts coming soon, and I'll put them out as soon as I've recorded and edited them. If you like this episode of Nanoloop Classroom, please consider leaving a like or subscribing. I don't make money from these videos, so if you feel like supporting me directly, there are links to my music on Bandcamp and streaming platforms in the description, along with links to support me directly monetarily, and some affiliate links to the equipment I use creating my music and videos. Thanks for watching.